Hey everyone, Clayton here. Normally, I'd never post a market closing video on a day like this with this much urgency, but I've got a blatant warning of things to come. I've been watching the data in a number of different sectors, and I want to make sure you knew about the incoming earthquake that we're about to see. Now, this is not meant to scare you, but it's instead meant to prepare you and your family, because the last thing I want to do is to sit on the sidelines while you're sitting there with your terrible 401k plan, and then you get hit hard, punched right in the stomach. So hard, in fact, that you'll never get back up again. I've got a big personal grudge against the system, the way it's constructed right now. Many of you know that who've watched my show for any length of time, the way it keeps people poor, the way that we don't teach financial intelligence in our schools and our colleges. Mainstream media keeps people stupid, and our elected officials would rather tell you that the US dollar is the only way to build wealth. And they've been always scared of telling us the truth, always. In fact, if you asked a government official about what I'm about to talk to you about today, they'll lie straight to your face. They'll dodge the question, just like former Fed Chief Alan Greenspan did. Privately, he was a huge fan of gold. Most people don't know this about him. But when he became Fed Chief, he basically had to lie right to our faces and pretend that gold was the enemy of the state, that the only true currency was the US dollar. Well, guess what? He leaves the job and then suddenly starts spouting off about how amazing gold is and why it's the ultimate store of wealth. Here he is, 13 years ago, on Fox Business Network, after he left the job. Listen to this.
So then, why do we need a central bank?
Well, the question is a very interesting one. We have, at this particular stage, a fiat money, which is essentially money printed by a government, and it's usually the central bank which is authorized to do so. Some mechanism has got to be in place that restricts the amount of money which is produced, either a gold standard, a currency board, or something of that nature, because unless you do that, all of history suggests that inflation will take hold with very deleterious effects on economic activity.
Oh, wow. Great. Thanks, Alan. So why did you lie to us while you were head of the Fed? Now the same thing is happening. Jerome Powell, who's the current Fed chief, he's telling us that Bitcoin is perhaps better than gold as a store of value. Why? Because governments around the world are trying to cut off Bitcoin at the knees, and he knows that gold is here to stay. These guys will always lie to us because they don't want to admit that their spending habits are going to drive the US dollar into the ground. I mean, just look at the national debt clock right now. Just look at how fast it's growing. While you've been watching me for the past 2 or 3 minutes, the national debt, in other words, the amount of money the government has spent, has grown by $9 million, which comes out to $50,000 a second. A second. Each and every second, 24 hours a day, 365 days a year. Let me just put it to you this way. No other country has ever been so deeply in debt since the dawn of civilization. As many of you know, I was a history major in college, and all you need to do is read Jared Diamond's great book, amazing book, called Collapse, to see how America is following in the exact same collapse patterns as other major civilizations in the world. Or pick up Jim Rickard's amazing book. It's phenomenal. It's called Road to Ruin, and see where the US dollar is headed right now. So how does this impact your own life? Well, let me show you. Let's go to the charts, shall we? Because this graph shows you the value of a dollar in the year 1913. In this example, let's start with $100. Look at that rise over the years up to 2018. It would take $2,529 just to match the same $100 in buying power in the year 1913. That means a dollar in 1913 had the same buying power as $26 in the year 2020. And guess what? That's never going backwards. It's only going to get worse. You're not going to start paying less for a Big Mac. You're only ever going to pay more for a Big Mac. And we just got the inflation numbers this week. Consumers saw a 5% increase in prices across the board, from milk to meat to eggs, fruit, houses, you name it, and you're paying more for all of it. A decline in the dollar's value eats away at your standard of living. And since the recession of 2007 to 2009, the rich have just gotten richer. As of the tax year 2018, the top 10% of earners took home almost 50% of all adjusted gross income reports on tax returns. Yeah, the top 1% earned 20% of all income. And you know what smart investors understood back in the year 2000 when the dot-com bubble burst and the government was printing money like crazy? Instead of putting $100,000 in the bank in 2000, many people chose to take those savings and put them into gold, which is a far superior form of savings. Guess what? Do you know what happened to them? Well, as you can see, their $100,000 would be worth way more today. How much more? Well, instead of $100,000, they'd be sitting on $700,000. I'll say it again because it's that important. Choosing gold over cash savings is the difference between now having $700,000 and a measly $100,000. The problem with gold, as I've mentioned many, many times on this show, is that you need to physically store it someplace. So what I did was look for a way to easily and simply own gold without actually having to store it, like in my house. And over the past few years, I made some really smart investments in gold producers that are sitting on literal gold mines or multiple untapped gold mines that they haven't even fully drilled yet or even started drilling. In some cases, taking that $100,000 and instead of turning it into $700,000, turning it into $3 million. Way bigger returns than just holding gold. So finding these hidden gems is what I do best. And owning precious metals is wonderful. But owning companies that actually produce gold is an absolute game changer. And it's often hundreds of times more profitable than buying actual physical gold. Now, there's a massive gold project called the Golden Rose Project. The reason I'm showing you this is because it's kind of like a rose between two thorns. It's sitting between two incredible gold mining projects right now, and it's untapped at this point. And it may be the largest untapped gold resource in Canada. And a company you've never heard of, maybe you've heard of them, but I don't think you have, they own this project along with multiple other mines in this area. The company's market cap soared from $700,000 in March 2020, right when the pandemic was unfolding, now to $20 million a few days ago on June 15th. This gold producer is called TRU, T-R-U, and TRU's market catalysts are stunning. The name of the company is TRU Precious Metals Corporation. That's the full name. And here is the U.S. stock symbol. It's T-R-U-I-F. You can trade it on E-Trade or one of the other big platforms. So look, the company not only announced the commencement of its Twilight drilling project on June 1st, and then a week later, they announced that they were doubling their drilling there. The potential should not be ignored, especially before drilling results are even released. And when that happens, you know what happens, right? The stock explodes. So I'm showing you this before the stock explodes. So why am I so bullish on TRU Precious Metals Corporation? Well, a couple of big reasons, and I'll go through them now. Number one, all of this untapped mining in some of the best and most profitable gold veins in the world. Number two, the executive team of this company is pretty jaw-dropping. Now, if you know anything about gold exploration, then you'll recognize some of these names on the company's roster. They have over 30 years experience mining gold in this part of Canada. And number three, speaking of Canada, another reason I'm so bullish is because this section of Canada in Newfoundland has largely been ignored. And it was just ranked as one of the top 10 best gold jurisdictions in the world. So basically, the secret of Newfoundland has now been uncovered. And TRU could be right there on the ground floor as an early mover. TRU is in the rare situation right now of having both real estate upside and mineral upside. Newfoundland has never seen a gold rush like this before. It is buzzing. So the bottom line on all of this is the U.S. government is going to continue printing money, boatloads of it. It's going to lead to a road to ruin. The national debt and deficit are set to soar much higher, and gold will be incredibly important. TRU Precious Metals has built itself into a mining company in the heart of an underexplored top 10 world mining jurisdiction with massive upside potential. Now, I'll have links in the description for you to dig in, learn more about the company, do your own due diligence. And also check out this next video on the trouble that is coming for the US dollar. Click here to watch it.